Hello everyone. So in last period we already started the new lesson, that is a light. So students, a light is none other, light is a form of energy. So a light is having electromagnetic waves and the speed of light is 3 multiplied by 10 raised to 8 meter per second. So these things we already discussed in last period. So we discussed something else, that is reflection of light. The reflection of light is none other, when the light rays fall on the surface of the mirror, so that time they return back with the same medium but in the opposite direction. So that is known as the reflection of light, and in a simple way reflection of light is known as the bouncing off. Okay, bouncing off means just like when we throwing the ball, so that time it is come back, so that is known as the bouncing off. Now in today's period, let us discuss about the laws of reflection. So here we will discuss about the laws of reflection. So students, there are two laws of reflection, so we will discuss about that. So first, consider, this is a surface of mirror. So when this one is normal ray, so when the incident ray, so the ray which is fall on the surface, that ray is known as the incident ray. So this one is an incident ray and it is denoted by using I. Okay, so when the incident ray falls on the surface of the mirror, so that time it gets reflect. So same medium se wo kya ho jayega, reflect ho jayega, and this one is known as the reflected ray. ओके, सो जो रे आता है उस रे को हम इंसिडेंट रे बोलते हैं, और जो रिफ्लेक्ट होता है दैट रे इज नोन एज द रिफ्लेक्टेड रे, एंड द रे विच इज प्रेजेंट हियर दैट इज नोन एज द नॉर्मल रे. नाउ जस्ट सी समथिंग रिलेटेड विद द एंगल बिटवीन द इंसिडेंट रे एंड द नॉर्मल रे. द एंगल बिटवीन द इंसिडेंट रे एंड द नॉर्मल रे दैट इज नोन एज द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस. Okay, the angle between the normal and the incidence ray, that is known as the angle of incidence, and the angle between the reflected ray and the normal ray is known as the angle of reflection. Okay, so I think these things are clear. So incident ray, normal ray and the reflected ray. So the first law of reflection is the incident ray, normal ray and the reflected ray lies in the same plane. Okay, the first law of reflection is the incident ray, normal ray and the reflected ray lies in the same plane. Okay, जो तीनों भी एंगल है वो सेम प्लेन में lies करते हैं. Now the next law is, यहाँ पे हमने देखा angle of incidence and angle of reflection. So according to the law of reflection, angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. It means that if the angle between normal ray and incident ray is 45 degree, so the angle of normal and reflection, it should be 45 degree Celsius. Okay, so according to the second law of reflection, the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So these things related with the reflection. Now move towards the spherical mirror. So now we are going to discuss about the spherical mirrors. So here is the spherical mirror. So definition of the spherical mirror, actually spherical mirror hai kya? So the spherical mirror is the mirror whose reflecting surface is the part of hollow sphere of glass. Okay, spherical mirror is the mirror whose reflecting surface is the part of hollow sphere of glass. Okay, वहाँ पे जो भी उसका reflecting surface है, that is a hollow sphere of glass. And the spherical mirror is having two types. Spherical mirror is having two types. So the first is concave mirror and the second part is convex mirror. Okay, so the spherical part, spherical mirror is having two types. One is the convex mirror and another one is a concave mirror. So we will see what is meant by the convex mirror and the concave mirror. So let us discuss about the concave mirror and the convex mirror. Here is a concave mirror and a convex mirror. Okay, so concave mirror. So students, here you can see the diagram of the concave mirror and the convex mirror. So the concave mirror means that this mirror whose surface is curved inward, okay, जिसका surface inside towards the center, जिसका जो curve है वो towards the center curve होता है, that is known as the concave mirror. And opposite to the concave mirror, in the convex mirror you can see that the surface is outward, उसका जो curve surface होता है, that surface is outward, it means that it is opposite to the center, okay. In a concave mirror it means that the surface is inward, it is a curved surface is inward, it means that it is towards the center, and the surface is outward, it means that it is opposite to the center. So in the concave mirror the reflecting surface is inward, and in case of the convex mirror the reflecting surface is outward. So I think you got the point. Now here is the center C. The center C is known as the center of curvature. In both the cases, in the concave mirror and in convex mirror, the C, the center is known as the center of curvature, and the center of the sphere is known as the pole axis. It is denoted by using P. So the center of sphere, the center of the surface is denoted by using P, and it is known as the pole axis, and the center of the mirror, it is denoted by using C, and it is known as the center of curvature. So this point C is known as the center of curvature. The point which is present at the center of the sphere, that point is known as the principal axis. The point P is known as the pole. Here also C is known as the center of curvature, and point P is known as the pole, and the line CP is known as the principal axis. Line C is known as the principal axis. So student, and the radius of the convex mirror and the concave mirror is denoted by using R. Okay, so these things are related with the convex mirror and the concave mirror. In the convex mirror and the concave mirror, here you can see the reflecting surface also. In this mirror's concave mirror it is inward, and in the convex mirror it is outward. Then it is towards the center, and it is opposite to the center. Then the line, the center point is known as the center of curvature. The point which is present at the center of the sphere, that is known as the pole, from both the sides, in case of the convex and in case of the concave mirror. And the line CP is known as the principal axis. So these things related with the convex mirror and the concave mirror. In next period we will discuss about the characteristics of the convex and the concave mirror. I hope till now your concepts are clear. If you are having any doubt, so you can ask me. So for today, thank you very much student. We will meet in next period. Thank you very much.